another samurai today. This time is a brown banana samurai. So we're just joining a 3.2 inner and a 1.8. Or sorry, a 1.8 inner and a 3.2 outer. And then we're going to play a butt of Opal Mirage. Tie that in, take it back, and put on a few turns of our Opal Mirage. Now, I'm going to play a little adhesive lead diamond, and that just gives a little bit of weight to our fly and also keeps it swimming on an even keel. So I've cut that off, maybe we'll see it in a little diamond shape. I'm going to turn my tube upside down and apply that on up here in where I suppose what you'd call the sort of thorax area, and that'll create a little keel for us. Right. Next we're going to put on a bit of gold holographic flat braid. Wrap that forward until we start coming up our lead portion. Then tie it off and fold it back on itself and tie over a couple of wraps just to keep it in place. We need a dubbin ball of gold light braid. And you want this straggly with fibers pointing out of it all over the place. So I'm going to use this sort of banana off yellow coloured fox. Apply that up on top, and we're going 1.5-2 lengths of the fly tube here with the yellow portion. Strands of some sort of flash material. Here I'm using a crystal hair, but you could use mirage, you can use whatever you want basically. Right, now we need to top on this. So we're going to use a bit of a fiery brown for it. A variety of different shades, light, medium, and dark. I think on this one I'm going to go with this darker coloured tanuki fur. Few strands of slightly longer temple dog hair just to give me a better taper on the end, because tanuki tends to be quite flat ended. And that's giving me a little bit better taper. A little bit. few strands of peacock hair there on top. And cut off our tag ends. And then I want to find a couple of jungle cock set them on. Now because samurais have a ball of dubbin at the front, you don't have to be overly tidy with the tie-in points of any of this, which also makes it quite a quick type of tube to tie. I'm just going to glue my tie-in thread a little bit there and wrap that on. On the front of this one, I'm going to mix my gold light bright with an olive light bright. And create quite a rough straggly dubbin ball. And to make it that bit more straggly, I'm going to take my bunch of the same dubbin, tie it across its middle, and then fold it back on itself. And that will give me a nice sort of halo effect of Angelina type fibers. Just going to pick them out a wee bit. Brush it out. Right, I'm going to take a banana soft apple and put on a couple of turns of that. I'll put this, I'm just going to double it over on itself. And I'm only looking for the longer fibers, so take off quite a bit of the tip this time. And wrap on a few turns of our banana soft tackle. Glue my thread a little bit. Now, what I'll do is take a cock pheasant rump feather here, and these ones are actually the brown feathers from the back end of a rump, and this one has been dyed in a sort of a olivey colour, so it should complement what we already have on there. So just grab it by its tip and I'll fold it over and double that and tie it in by the tip, fold it back over on itself, and then we'll wrap this sort of brown olive cock pheasant rump, which is quite like heron, so it gives this fly a sort of a spey appearance. Trim that. Thread. on this one, I'm going to put on sort of a gold hybrid coat. Set that onto our tube holder. Hybrid cone back into that, then remove it, trim down our tube, finished. That is a brown top banana samurai.